Hey guys, I'm Abhay Sharma for Thinking Penguin and welcome to my channel. Today I'll show you how you can create long shadow effect in Blackmagic Fusion, which is a very basic element of motion graphics design. Long shadow effect is very popular these days, so I thought why not create it in Fusion. Long shadow design is same thing as flat color design, except it has a long shadow. So we will be creating this effect in Fusion as fast as possible. But before that, if you haven't heard the news, then let me tell you. Fusion is free. Free as in free beer. It is available for Windows, Mac and Linux. So what are you waiting for? Go grab it as soon as possible and start creating awesome visual effects and motion graphics. And I am using the Linux version, which is running pretty smooth. I'm just saying. Alright, let's get started. This is our node tree. And these nodes are creating the long shadow effect. It can be converted into a macro which can be used in the future. First of all, I'll create a background node. And let's assign a bright color. Next, we'll create a text node which will cast the shadow. Type something. Text is not important, you can use any object as long as it's in the composition bound and has an alpha channel or transparency. I'm gonna choose character level styling, then go to the modifiers tab and open character level styling 1. I'll select the fusion text and increase the font size. And then I decrease the line spacing. Alright, let's merge it. Add a transform node to the text. Let's just focus on the text right now. I'm going to copy the transform node and paste it as an instance. Then connect the text to this transform also. Let's apply a blur effect. But I need to blur only the alpha channel, so I'll turn off RGB channels. Unlock the XY size and change the value of X to 0 and Y to, let's say, 100. Now it's time for the magic node. Apply the channel boolean tool and change the operation to divide. It's looking slightly weird, so I'll change the blur type to box. Now it looks better. Let's create a background node. It will serve us as a shadow color. Connect the channel boolean's output to mask input of background node. Now I'm going to merge it with the original text and see how it looks like. Okay, the shadow is in the foreground, so I'll toggle the inputs by pressing the Ctrl plus T. Alright, let's now merge it with the background. Let's change the shadow color and then reposition it. I'll pick the same color as the background, but I'll make it darker. Let's change the hue a little bit. Alright, so far so good. Now we will change the shadow direction. Select the instance transform node and try to change the angle value. You can see text and shadow both are rotating simultaneously because they are connected. I want to rotate just the shadows, not the text. So what I'll do is disconnect or deinstance the angle value from the transform node. Now shadows are rotating independently. Let's set it to 45 degrees. But as you can see, it's not matching with the text. We have to rotate this shadow exactly in the opposite direction. So let's add a transform node before the merge node and change the angle value to negative 45 degrees. Don't worry about the clipping, we'll fix it later. But still we have to reposition the shadow to match with the text. So let's select the instance transform node and try to reposition it. It's not moving as expected because both centers are connected. We have to deinstance the center as well. Now let's adjust the shadow. For the direction of the shadow, if we can somehow connect the instance transform angle to reverse transforms angle, then we can avoid some extra work. You know, like whenever you want to change the angle of the shadow, you have to reverse it also. What if it can change itself? Well, it can be done using expressions. So let's select the instance transform node and pin it. Then select the reverse node, reverse transform node, and then right click on the angle and choose expression. Then I'll pick with the angle attribute of the instance transform node and multiply it by -1, which will reverse the value. Now if we change the angle value, you can see it's working as expected. Alright, let's deal with this clipping issue. Actually, we just have to increase the image size of the relevant nodes. In this case, we have to change the image size of the text node and the shadow color node. We can go higher than 2000 depending on the length of the shadow. Unfortunately, we have to reposition the shadow again. It can be solved by expression also, but right now I'm still learning expression, so I'll just skip it. I think we need to change the image size again because it looks like being clipped. Let me quickly adjust it. Okay, it's not clipping actually, I just have to increase the blur size. So let's set it to 200. Or maybe 150. Reposition it again. Alright, so basically we are done, but let me show you how can you add a little bit of variation in shadow density. It's pretty easy. Select the shadow color node and change the color mode from solid color to gradient. Then change the point locations and colors accordingly. I think it should be more darker. Let's give it a simple animation. I think I need to make the animation a little longer. I don't like scrolling timeline, I feel dizzy, so I'll change the scale to manual. So So that's the basic idea behind long shadow effect. You can achieve the same effect with other notes as well, like directional blur note or raise note if you have an OpenCL device. The point is, there are so many ways you can achieve the same effect. Well, that's the beauty of Fusion. Alright guys, let me show you quickly what I have done in the other composition that I have shown you in the beginning. So basically I have started with an element which can be anything. In my case it's a rectangle. Then I have an animated stroke which is acting as a mask to reveal the shape of the rectangle. Then I have a text F which reminds me Fusion 6. Next I have the stroke animation to support the formation. Then we have the long shadow effect which you have already seen. Oh, I don't think I need bitmap mask. Sorry for that, my mistake. Then I merged it with the background. For the background, I have created a simple animation. Just animated a polyline mask and then duplicated it, flipped it and merged it to create this closing door effect. Then I duplicated and merged it again. I have just changed the color of the background to give it some more variation. Then I merged it on a white background. Then I added the text element. And finally I have added some stroke animations. Just change the shape from rectangle to circle. And that's pretty much it. Alright guys, I hope you liked the tutorial, and if you liked it, then please subscribe, like and share. So enjoy, I'll see you next time, bye bye.